हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, माई सेल्फ मनोरंजन। टुडे वील डिस्कस अबाउट योर 10th एक्सपेरिमेंट ऑफ योर फिजिक्स लैब। सी हियर, योर एम ऑफ द एक्सपेरिमेंट इज टू वेरीफाई द लॉज ऑफ ट्रांसवर्स वाइब्रेशन ऑफ ए स्ट्रिंग बाय सोनोमीटर। अपरेटस रिक्वायर्ड्स आर सोनोमीटर, ट्यूनिंग फॉर्क एटलीस्ट 3 और ए हैंगर विथ स्लॉटेड वेट। इन दिस एक्सपेरिमेंट वील यूज 500 ग्राम स्लॉटेड वेट एंड थियोरी। इफ ए फ्लेक्सिबल वायर ऑफ लेंथ एल stressed under tension is pulled aside and left, transverse waves will move along the wire. These waves will be reflected at the ends and will produce stationary vibrations on the string. So, laws of transverse vibration of a string can be stated as follows. First one is your law of length, where n is inversely proportional to l. That is written as n is proportional to 1 by n, where t and m are constant. That implies n into l equal to constant. Then law of tension, n is directly proportional to square root of t, where l and m are constant. If n equal to constant, then l is directly proportional to square root of t. That means t by l square is equal to constant. Third one is your law of mass. Is n is directly proportional to l into square root of m, where l and t are constant. If n equal to constant, then l is directly proportional to t whole into m square root of m. That implies m l square equal to constant, where l is your length of the wire, n is your frequency of the tuning fork, m is your mass per unit length, t is your tension. See here, this one is your sonometer having two bridges. Let this one is your bridge 1 and this one is your bridge 2. And these are tuning fork having frequency 256, 288, 320 like this. And this one is your rubber pad. And here is your hanger with load. See here. So for first law, that is law of length, n is inversely proportional to m, where t and m are constant. And C, let P2 is constant at 70. Then we have to find for position B1. C, see here, जहां पर ये पेपर थ्रेड गिर जाएगा, we have to find the position for B1 is how much. And here position is 45.3. So write here, B1 is 45.3 and B2 is your 70. It is constant for all the readings. See, then take 288. And position for B2 is 48.1. And B2 also constant at 70. Then we will find difference. Then 1 by L, then N into L. Similarly, find for 320.
then position of B1 is 50.3, then we will find difference, then 1 by L, then N into L. This one is for law of length. Then for law of tension, your frequency is constant. See here, let's take 256 always. Then here we have to change only your tension. Here tension is your load. Yahan pe tension load de rahe. So load is your tension. Now load is 2500 grams. See here. Your tension T is your 2500 gram fast. See. For your fast double also, tension is equal to 2500 gram. Ye tha abhi 2500, abhi jo hai. Theek hai, dekho. For 2500 gram, you have to use 256 frequency. See here. We have found the readings for 256. So note down 256 ke liye 2500 ke liye first reading was your 45.3, then write 45.3, then unload 1500 gram load. See here, we have to unload 1500 gram load. Now tension is 2000 gram. So for 2000 we have to find position for B1 is how much. See here, then position of B1 is 46.4. Then unload another 500 gram load. Now load is your 1500 gram. So see, use 256 also, then find position for B1 is how much. Then position for B1 is 38.4. Then we have to find difference. Then difference is your L. Then we have to find L square. Then we have to find T by L square. And these are the readings. See your observation. Table 1, that is table for verification of law of length. Number of observation, frequency, N in hertz. Position of bridge B1 in centimeter, position of bridge B2 in centimeter, difference L in centimeter, that is L is equal to B2 minus B1, then 1 by L in centimeter inverse, then N into L, that is in horse centimeter. So see here, we have to use 3 tuning pump, that is 256, 288 and 320, and these are the data we have found from your experiment. And see here, table 2, table for verification of law of tension. Similarly, number of observation T in gram, position of bridge B1 in centimeter, position of bridge B2 in centimeter, difference L in centimeter, that is L is equivalent to B2 minus B1, then frequency in hertz, all are constant, that is 256, then L square in centimeter square, then T by L square in gram per centimeter square. And your tension is here 2500 gram, 2000 gram and 1500 gram. For this tension, these are the data we have found from your experiment. See here, this graph is for law of length. So for law of length, in x axis we will take frequency, that is 0, 256, 288, 320. Then in y axis, we will take 1 by L, that is 0.04 to 0.05. So 0.04, then 0.0405, 0.041, is tara 0.05. Then see here, 250 pe this point, 288 pe this point, and 320 pe this point. Then add this and graph will be a straight line. See here, for law of tension, in x axis we will take tension, that is load in gram, 0 500, 1000, 1500, 2000, 2500, means 30 small division or 3 big division pe liye 500 gram. And in y axis we will take t square, that is L square, that is 466.56 to 610.09, this value. And see here, graph also straight line. And for law of mass, see here, for law of mass, actually mass is the mass of unit length of this string. So practically it is difficult to find law of mass. So here we will verify only two, that is law of length and law of tension, because mass is the mass of unit length of this string. We have to find the unit length of this string and weight it in its physical balance. So that's why we will do here only two, law of length and law of tension, not law of mass. See here, conclusion from table 1, NL is found to be nearly constant. Also the graph of N versus 1 by L is a straight line. This verifies the law of length. And second one is from table 2. It is observed that T by L square is nearly constant. Also the graph of T versus L square is a straight line. That means this verifies the law of tension. Thank you.